When we talk about Twin Towers and when we talk about these two, it's really amazing how they're able to really adjust to the system of NU. I mean, we've seen Lacsina play last year as a wing spiker, and transitioning to middle is not easy, but she's been able to make it work. And not only make it work in a mediocre style, but really excel also in that position. Having 5 blocks in a game as a transitional middle player from wing is not easy, but not only in her defense, she's not only a threat, and they're not only threats in their blocking, which by the way, NU is number one blocking after 2 games, but they're also a threat in offense. So a combination of both really makes this duo very lethal. So for me, they just really need to work more on their consistency and their efficiency, because most of the sets and most of the attempts, 50% of the attempts in the past 2 games went to these 2 players. So kailangan talaga mas maging more consistent sila in the coming games.
Yeah, tama yung sinabi ni Charo na I understand for Ivy Lacsina din, mahirap talaga yung transition na mag-wing spiker ka tas maging middle spiker. Pero nakita naman natin yung consistency din ni Ivy Lacsina in the middle. Though yung mga spikes niya, hindi siya ganun na quick spikes, madaming differential or mataas na bola, pero nagagawa niya yun ng paraan. So, slowly but surely, all throughout the conference, makikita natin yung magiging development ni Ivy sa gitna, and yung agility na din niya, yung bilis ng pag-blockings, and yung tulong for the team as well. And si Margot naman, alam naman natin na go-to girl talaga siya. But though there's still a lot of points to develop, especially pag nasa backline siya, yung reception niya and defense, but the league is still, ano pa naman, kaka-start pa lang. So mahaba pa to, madami pa tayong makikita from these two leagues.